Hi everybody, welcome to Viewer's Comment and Question, episode 3. I'll try to make this one a little shorter than the other one, because, you know, videos are too long anyway. The first question today is from DJXMP. Can you have a Behringer wing for front of house and a Behringer X32 for broadcast? Yes, all you need to do is to connect the console together over a Cat5e shielded, so they will speak AES50. So let's say AES50B from your wing to AES50A of your X32 and use that to do your mix. Use the USB out to send to your computer. You can do your own stuff on the X32. For your broadcast, just be aware that you won't have gain control. The first console in the chain will have gain control, the preamp control. So you have a 20 dB trim, so plus 20, minus 20. That's the only kind of gain control that you will have on your broadcast X32. Or if the X32 is your main console, the wing will only have the trim setting, not the gain control of the preamp. It's not like you physically split the preamp, it's just like they are gain sharing. Great news, life coming back in Canada. For how long though? Anyways, enjoy it as long as possible. This is Patrick Gilles Maillot, one of the guys who's working on the wing. We did an interview together that was on my YouTube channel before I deleted it. Yeah, I gotta keep coming with that. He's writing the OSC control for the wing. He created a software called Reaper Automate for the X32, and he's also working for Automate for Wing. I will leave a link in the description below for his stuff. Really interesting to see what Patrick is doing. I know he's watching this channel, so merci d'être à l'écoute. Great video, looks like happened to be the 150th sub. Thank you very much, David. Yes, things are slowly coming back. Like I said a few seconds ago, I deleted my YouTube channel by accident. So yeah, things are slowly coming back. Thank you everybody for subscribing, really appreciate it. A couple weeks ago, some people were questioning me about my Siri that I do on the compressor and gate of the wing. I decided to try every single input that I have on my virtual sound check and try every compressor and every gate on it. A gentleman that I don't remember his name, I'm so sorry, I'm sure he will recognize himself, asked me if the compressor were only a reskin of the original compressor from the wing. With different parameter. And I asked out some guy who works at Music Tribe. They gave me the permission to say the information that I'm gonna tell you right now, just to keep everything clean. I'm not gonna give out name for now. So the first gentleman answered my question about the compressor. I asked, are they just a reskin, a nice picture with less or more feature on it? And the answer was the detector circuit, the envelope, and the timing characteristic curve are all modeled after the original circuit. The basic design of a comp, however, is just a simple gain cell. So with non-dynamic constant signal, you won't find any difference. That is to be expected. We're not modeling the subtle nonlinear saturation and transformer effect due to resource constraint, which makes sense. What that means is the compressor is, it's recreating the design, but not the flaws of those compressors. Some of those have output transformer that distort or had some resistance. They do not model that. A second gentleman from the Music Tribe came in and said, the sound of a compressor is depending on how the gain is controlled and adjust, not the gain or gain reduction itself. In our test, we couldn't detect any important effect of the transformer that will justify the considerable additional resources for nonlinear processing. Because the IN equipment at the time, which we are modeling, was designed for lowest possible distortion anyway, and they were in no way expecting to add anything else than their specific fingerprint to compression. That's what our model are faithfully replicating. What I understand from that message is the compressor are really there to recreate a perfect version of the one that you choose in the rack. If you want a perfect 160 compressor, you got it there. It won't add the transformer saturation, it won't have all that non-desirable stuff. It's probably closer to a perfect schematic version of those compressor and not maybe the unit that you have in your rack, because that unit have some power variations. Your unit may have some component tolerance that do not reproduce the circuit perfectly, but the one that we have in the wing are perfect version from what I understand. Thank you very much for watching, guys. This is a shorter episode this week. Keep those questions coming. It's always a pleasure for me to answer them for you. Until the next video, please take care of yourself, and I see you guys later.